Here I'm asked to rationalize with a binomial in the denominator. Okay, now the way to do that is to multiply numerator and denominator by its conjugate. So here we had square root of 3 minus square root of 2, so the conjugate is going to be plus the square root of 2. Whatever you multiply the denominator by, you also have to multiply the numerator by the exact same thing. Okay, now watch what happens when you do this. Certainly in the numerator, you're going to be left with square root of 3 plus the square root of 2. In the denominator, you've got to distribute. So square root of 3 times square root of 3 is square root of 9. Square root of 3 times square root of 2 is plus square root of 6. Negative square root of 2 times square root of 3 is minus square root of 6. And then negative square root of 2 times square root of 2 is minus square root of 4. Okay, now this will always happen when you multiply conjugates. Plus square root of 6 and minus square root of 6, those terms are going to add to 0. And that leaves us with the square root of 9, which is 3, minus the square root of 4, which is 2. No more radical in the denominator. And that's the goal. The numerator here, we're left with square root of 2, or I'm sorry, square root of 3 plus the square root of 2. Okay, and then just simplifying further, square root of 3 plus the square root of 2 over 1, 3 minus 2, that's just square root of 3 plus square root of 2. So this is equivalent to the original fraction with no radicals in the denominator.